YouTube. I am Pinstar, and this is No Man's Sky Strategy and Tactics, episode 1. Episode 1 here is going to entail some getting started strategies. And you might be saying, Pinstar, where's the game? I mean, I see the page for the game here, but you're not actually in the game, and you usually start your episodes in the game. Well, there's a reason I'm starting my game, my episode here, outside the game. And that is my first tip. A lot of people have been asking, myself included, how the heck do you restart a fresh game in this game? I mean, when you start the game, it just throws you into the world, and every time you go back into the game, it doesn't ask you to choose a save file. It just tosses you right into your old save file. And you know, that's not so good if you want to start a brand new game here. So let me show you how. Now, I happen to have the GOG version of No Man's Sky here installed. But you should be able to do similarly with the Steam version or the DRM-free version. So what you want to do is, I'm also in the Windows 10 version of, for operating system's sake. Go down here and bring up your run command prompt. Like so. Now what you want to do is you want to put in percentage signs, app data, percentage sign, like that. That's all you really need here. And that's going to bring you into your app data folder here. My precursor here is obviously Pinstar, because that's what I'm called on my computer, but your mileage may vary. But the app data roaming folder should be what comes up for you. And you can see all the different games you have installed. What you want to locate is Hello Games, the maker of No Man's Sky. Go into here. And you see an NMS folder. Go into there. Now this is the folder in question. You don't want to go any deeper. You don't actually want to go into the folder. This is the folder. So this folder right here is essentially your save game. So if we were to delete this and go back into the end of the game, we'd start afresh. Another thing you can do is if you want to, say you have several different save games going at once, just rename one. I happen to be quite attached to the world I've been playing, or the universe that I've been playing, or rather the game that I've been playing, offline here, and I do not want that to go by the wayside. So I'm going to rename it, just default user offline. And as long as there isn't a folder that is strictly called default user, the game won't see that there's one and think that you're starting up the game first, right off the bat. The upshot of this is it does remember your graphical and options settings. So if you did all the tweaking that you need to do to get the game running the way you want it to, you can do that. All right, without any further ado, let's dive right in, shall we? For those of you who are not familiar with what this game actually is, it is a procedurally generated freeform space exploration game called No Man's Sky. And yes, it's been recently released to a lot of fanfare, a little bit of growing pains from here to there. But I am having fun with it. So now, this is the screen you get when you have a brand new thing. Now, I've also already remapped all my keys, so since I'm a lefty, I don't press the E key. This is your interact key. So I have no idea. This is a brand new start, so I have no idea what kind of world we're about to get here.
Life support systems activated.
But the presence of trees is not a bad sign. Could be a hot planet.
System online.
Nice big pillar of resources there, potentially.
Scanner damaged. Repair required.
Let's see, 66.9 degrees Celsius. Oh yeah, it's a hot planet.
Aerial propulsion jetpack online.
That's okay.
Multi-tool and mining laser attachment. Operational.
All right, we start with our starter multi-tool. Let's see the stats on this planet.
User initialization sequence complete.
Wintry? Really? Limited, bountiful, and regular. All right, not too shabby. I see a dinosaur in the background there. Okay. oh, it's minus 66.9. I said, what to say? It's like, I thought this was a hot planet. Well, that's okay. It's a cold planet, but not too horrifically cold here. Right then. So, getting started here. Let's pick through our debris. And your first choice of the game is this thing. Do you want to go the Atlas path or not? What you ultimately decide in this route is up to you. I'm going to spurn the direction, but either way is pretty viable here. But I don't need no Atlas direction. You also always start with one of these damaged machineries. This will give you a starship tech. Beam impact. No. Just no. Cargo drop. Shielding shard. I'm probably going to toss that out. Useful in a pinch, and I'll keep it in case we run out of room. Alright, so let's take a look at our starship. Take stock of what we need to do to get this Lark back in the air. Alright, so we have one car 8 sheet. We need three more to get the launch thruster going. We also need one more car 8 sheet, or two more, and peridium and zinc. So car 8 sheets are made out of carbon, so our three target materials to be gathered in this first phase is iron, peridium, and a little bit of zinc. You only really need one or two plants worth of zinc, though, so you don't have to go crazy. That also being said, your multi-tool is also something you want to take stock of here. Now, the analysis visor and the scanner. I don't like the analysis visor being right here. I'll show you why in a minute. But before, instead of repairing this one, I'm actually going to dismantle it. Because we're just going to rebuild it right here. Because we have the blueprint for it. The scanner's fine right there. But what you really want is you want like items to be next to each other. So scanny items, if they touch, they give each other a little bit of a bonus. Mining items and weapon items, bolt caster items touching and grenade items touching. Now, we don't exactly have a lot of room to play with on this little rinky-dink five-slot multi-tool, but we do want to optimize what we can until we get ourselves a real one. Right then, so we are going to need 50 iron in total to get this analysis visor built up, which is fine. We're also going to need some carbon for that scanner. All very common ingredients, so let's get out of here. All right, well, let's start with the carbon. Carbon comes from plant life for the most part. All right, so now we can also use the rest of our carbon to recharge our mining beam. All right, so now that we have our scanner repaired, we can scan. We can see some viable materials nearby. Now, there's a few other things you want to be doing while you're going around here. But first things first, let's get some iron here. Like that. Any old port in the storm. Really does not matter what you use. All right, now one other technique is, see how I interrupted that in the middle there? Oop. That way you don't overheat. It's faster to do it that way. Now, if one of these guys catches your attention here, let him scan the area, let him scan you. They're not going to attack as long as you stop mining while they are scanning you. They noticed something went wrong, but they're not too bright. They didn't put A to B, that I was the one that did that. So we can go ahead and build our analysis. So see how these two are glowing yellow now? That's because they're getting a synergy bonus because they're next to each other. How much the exact effect of the synergy bonus is, I don't actually know the raw numbers, but I guess in terms of scan, actually, does it say over here? It does not. It probably gives you a little bit more distance, so that when we do this scan, we'll find icons a little bit further than us. Oh, hey, a bonus crash thing. This one isn't hard scripted here to be here, but I'll take it. That's actually quite good. No, we're not going to be building it for quite some time, but it's a good tech to have. All right, now that we have ourselves our analysis visor, we can start analyzing things. And this goes for plants, this goes for animals, but mostly, and actually rock formations too. Just about everything can be analyzed here. Striped one? Yep, striped ones are a new species. The reason why we're doing this is turning in your scans. Is this actually materials? No, it's actually just ground deformation. Also, one other thing is if you start having, thermal protection or radiation or toxicity, just pop back into your ship real quick and you'll get your stuff back here. You'll refill your protection for free. If you're nearby. Obviously, you don't need to abandon your task at hand quite so easily. All right, we need more iron for these kerite sheets. There we go. How are we doing here? Need a bit more. We'll get these next two things here. All right. And that. The other thing you were going to want to be doing here, and let me just check our multi-tool here, is we want to, what do we need for our, we need some plutonium to get a bolt caster, which is easy enough to find. All right, but we have our kerite sheets. I think we can go repair our starship here, so let's manufacture those.
Product constructed.
Now, when you're close enough to your starship, the stuff inside your exosuit inventory and your starship inventory are both useful when it comes to repairing your stuff. So you don't need to migrate them all into the same place. Let's see. All right, we still need more kerite sheets. We've got enough iron to to make that happen, so we don't need to mine any more iron. So we need to go in search of a heridium spire and also some zinc plants. So let's start scanning. Also, we want a little bit of brain plutonium, and those are usually red lightning bolts. Now, they're not always red lightning bolts, as you can see here. This is not plutonium. This is the red flower, Thamian 9. Now, getting some Thamian 9, not the worst thing in the world. Also, we got some aminals here. So let's scan them.
Units received.
Now, two reasons for this. One, money. Two, more money later. Three, lots of money later if you scan all the animals. I'm not going to stick around to scan all of them, unless I accidentally wander into it. But four, to know if they are predators. Because if they are predators and they might hunt you, then you just need to be careful of them. Okay. We also want to look for yellow symbols, because those can be zinc, which we need. And two, when you have multiple lightning symbols next to each other, that's more likely to be plutonium. Yep, zinc also comes in the form of plants. And the game will prompt you with a heridium spire if you don't find one right away. Because the game knows you need heridium pretty badly and pretty early. You don't normally get this kind of hand-holding. Oh god, five? There's one 5 minutes away? Are you kidding me? F that. I hope that's not the closest one, because that's going to be a long, boring walk. And a long, tough walk, too, going in the cold here. Yeah, 5 minutes away. That is a long, long walk. Now, let me check something here. I want to see if I can... if you can, well, no, you can't take off without the pulse engines. God dang it. Well, that is pooish. That is pooish to the max. Oh, wait a minute. Isn't that a heridium spire? That looks like one. Yeah, that's Extreme
night temperature.
Oh detected. Boy. Alright. Ooh. Kryptonite. We don't need it, but it is rare and valuable. There's also a cave up here. Let us get to that cave to rest our temperature gauge here. Because in addition to your...
temperature levels stabilizing.
In addition to your ship, caves can also refill this for free. And while we're here, we can do some scanning. Get some cash money in the bank. You'd be surprised at the types of things that you can scan for deposits. Now, I'm not going to sit here and name every single one of these, but basically any ground-based shapes that are distinctive, but generally larger. Some of these, like these little tiny ferns, those are just incidentals. You're not going
to... support power. No.
Boy, this is one
hot... Extreme night temperature detected.
I hear ya. Why the heck did you point me all the way over there? Scared me half to death when there's a perfectly serviceable Heridium Spire over here. Whee. Oop, and another thing of zinc. Also, this little technique I'm doing, where I punch and then do my jet, that is a... well, it's a rocket punch, basically. You melee attack and then hold forward and do your jetpack. And that will let you carry your momentum much further forward than you normally would be able to. Before I start mining all of this, though, I do want to get my hands on some plutonium, and there's a reason for it. Yeah, there we go. Alright, now we can construct our bolt caster over here.
Technology installed.
Now, I'm actually not a big fan of the bolt caster, but we need to harvest up some titanium.
Hostiles approaching.
And you get titanium from these guys.
Sentinel drones activated.
Alright, where's the other sentinel drone? They always come in pairs, and you want to find and shoot the other one down. We want to get him before he calls for help. And also we want to get these little canisters that they drop. If you can kill two, you get a good amount of titanium. Yeah, so these things, you can get new techs out of those canisters. But mostly we were going that to farm up some titanium. The reason being is our beam intensifier Sigma that we know from the beginning here requires titanium. So now we have a beefier thing here, and we're getting a little synergy bonus here. Sweet. Okay, now I'm ready to go for that to harvest this Heridium Spire. Wait, did crap grow on there in the interim? Yeah, crap grew on there in the interim. That's kind of funny. And yes, I've killed sentinels. I'll probably be killing a lot more, and I'll show you once we get a slightly different bit of tech, some easier ways to farm up sentinels. Because they be good farming.
No free slots in suit inventory.
Oop. Okay, so when you have some, this problem here, first off, let me use my shielding shard to get a freebie recharge there. X button will teleport this stuff to your suit. Let's see. Thamium can go. Kryptonite I'll keep on my person. When you get trade commodities, keep them on your suit inventory, because your suit inventory can only hold 250 of, well, normal quantities, but your ship inventory slots can hold 500. But these things will take up a whole ship inventory if you send them there, so hold on to these in your suit inventory. Right then. More Heridium. You basically want to eat the whole spire here. Also, yeah, even though I just killed two sentinels, these guys, they're not too good at communicating. Once they've been deactivated. So you don't need to worry about, like, all the sentinels on the planet going hostile on me. And yes, I haven't been paying attention to my mining beam and turning it off before it overheats. But yeah, a whole spire should give you enough heridium, and then some, to be able to do what you need to do for the next part here. Excellent. I think we can, yep, these mushrooms we can get. Alright, let's make our way back to the ship. I think we got the zinc that we needed. Yes, we got enough zinc. So, we will be able to fix up our ship a bit more. If we see any more goodies along the way, of course, we're going to want to grab them. I see those lightning bolts close by, and we are going to want the plutonium. Because, well, it's useful to have a lot of. Oh! Cargo drops. Well, those usually still contain plutonium, so I'll take them. Platinum plants are also very good to get. They're not really useful for material-wise, but they're good for money-wise. And, you know what? More zinc doesn't hurt. Even though we don't need it, we can just gather as we go. You're going up a hill, try sprinting. It's a little bit more reliable of a technique than doing the rocket jumping. Well, hi there. Yep, I haven't scanned you yet. Sometimes you have to zoom in. Submissive grazing and creatures, so I got nothing to worry about. Alright, we are at 50% thermal, but that's okay. We're about to warm back up in our ship here. And we also need the two Karite sheets, but we still have the iron for that. Hold off on actually creating the Karite sheets until right before you need them, because they don't stack either. So you don't want those things filling up too much inventory. Alright, pulse engine is fixed. Let's fill you with plutonium. Fill you with the thamium. That's why I was bothering to pick that up. Alright. And, so yeah, now we can actually take off. Put that over there. Alright, let's take off, shall we? Whee! Alright, now, if you hit the scan button while in midair, you will pick up, local points of interest. And, I actually happen to eyeball them over here. And I see a launch pad! That is good. Alright. Now, wait for it. Did you hear that whip? That bip-bip? As soon as you hear that bip-bip, that means you're over the launch pad, and if you hit the landing button, you'll land on the launch pad.
Objective complete. Like
we just did there. Now, landing on a launch pad is really good for a couple of different reasons. One, you can take back off without burning any fuel, which is awesome. Two, if there is a trade interface in here, you can sell stuff straight out of your ship inventory, rather than just your exosuit inventory. There is. Ooh, and a multi-tool. Oh. Well, hello, my friend. Looks like this is a Viking system here. What you got for me? Yeah, I don't know any of your language, dude, so I'm going to be taking a guess here. It suddenly grabbed my barking into my visor. Let's give him that. Well, he seems to like that. Fair enough. I guess, like, interloper. That's a good one to learn. Alright, let's see what multi-tool tech we got here. Ooh, one of my favorites. One of my favorites. Okay, let's access this, because we're going to need to do some selling to get our cash up, because we're going to want to buy whatever multi-tool is sitting in there. Neutrino module. The excess titanium we can liquidate. The chrysonite we can liquidate. I know those are not the world's greatest prices, but that's okay. The platinum we can liquidate. Right now, we just want all the units we can get. And again, since we're on the landing pad, we can sell stuff right out of the starship. Ooh, 4%. You're not going to get any gold star stuff on here, but that's okay. All right, so we have sold everything that we can. The other thing that we can do is turn in our discoveries for cash money. I'm just going to upload these. I'm not going to rename them. 2,500 per animal, 500 per plant or rock formation. Later in the game, might be not so impressive, but early on. Also, you can rename the system and planet for cash, too. Now, these I will rename. I'm going to be a little narcissistic here. This is the Pin Star. And for this one, we're going to call it... Greenland. That looks like a Greenland type of planet. So now we've got almost 50k in the bank. Let's see what this thing's going for. Yes! So it is an 8-slot multi-tool with a couple of really, really good stuff, good things on it. Like, really freaking good. Amplifier tau, beam intensifier tau, and a plasma launcher? Come to daddy! This is what we want. Yes! Oh. Now we can do some even more improvements to this thing. First off, the scanner's in a bad spot. We need to get the scanner off of there. So, dismantle the scanner. Don't be afraid to dismantle cheap stuff. If it would serve you better to move it elsewhere on the gun. This is better served by having a, let's see, what do you mean? I shouldn't have sold the titanium, but I can always farm up more! Iron, heridium, plutonium. We can always farm up more. We're going to be on here, on this planet, for a little bit. And then we're going to want the scanner and the analysis visor down here to get the synergy bonus. And that will give us room for two more things. And this plasma launcher. We don't know how to build this, so we don't want to dismantle it. But it is so big that we get that plasma launcher. Such a useful tool. I told you before that I don't like the bolt caster. The reason I don't like the bolt caster is because it's not the plasma launcher. Alright, let us... well, first off, let's get some carbon so that we can get our scanning tools back online.
Technology installed.
Now we have our scanner back. Get our iron going here. And we can get our analysis fires back. Oh, here's why I like it. Watch this. One hit, one kill, and you don't take splash damage from it. Alright, where's our drone buddy? Is he hiding? He might be hiding. You want to get him before he scans you. Like that. And don't forget his canister. Where does canister go? I want that canister, damn it. But this is why the plasma launcher's so good. One hit kills on these guys. Dang it, where'd the canister go?
Thermal protection falling.
And where'd that canister here go? Yeah, unfortunately, it doesn't show up on scans. Alright, now these things often have stuff, and since we're close by a cellar here, we can pick them up and then just resell them so they don't... Aha! There's our debris. Neutrino module, perfect. More cash money in the bank. Where'd my other... Where'd my other canister go, yet, little bastard? Did it roll this way? Or did it just dissolve? Well, no matter. Let's see, what else? What do I need here? I got that. I need the heridium and more plutonium. Fair enough. Let me go inside to warm up a little bit. And also sell these little space wasters that I picked up. Oh, and a power canister. That's actually decent to hold on to for a little bit. Once our life support gets really low, we can just use the power canister to juice it back up. Alright, I see a heridium spire way up there. Let's see if we can find one a little closer. Let's also explore the rest of this camp. Also, I want to find the beacon for this camp. I mean, this is a pretty big settlement here. There's our entrance. Whee!
Temperature levels stabilizing.
Yeah, another pretty populous one here. Alright, what do you want from me? Yeah, they teach you interloper pretty early, and they say it a lot. I'll hand it over for now. An improved replacement multi-tool. Do I want it, though? 10 slots, beam coolant, ooh! Yes, sir. Because it still has the plasma launcher on it, and that beam coolant, that beam coolant is a big one. Yeah, that beam coolant is huge. All right. Well, hey. Multi-tools aplenty. Don't care. Don't care about the bolt thrower or whatever the heck you guys call that crap. Sometimes those will give you cash. All right, let's think reorganization. Now, I do need to get the tech for the plasma launcher because I want to move this. Because I want to link up the mining beam with the pre-built beam coolant system. Not gonna dismantle this because I don't know it. This range boost tau, nice. That's a really good thing. I am going to move this scanner, however, because that's easy to replace.
Technology installed.
And then, yeah, probably going to put the analysis visor here to get this triple going here. And then probably would stick the plasma launcher down here when I get the tech for it so I can just rebuild it. Because the plasma launcher is actually pretty cheap. And then I can make all the rest of this mining upgrades. Titanium and plutonium, fair enough! Alright, let me go find the beacon here. Ooh! Knowledge stone. Hang on! Alright, visual. And these guys, I don't think I've... Oh, no analysis visor. Well, let's fix that. Alright.
Technology installed.
Yep.
Units received.
If they have little green dots on them, that means you've scanned them before. Red dots means you haven't. And there's something new and unique.
Units received.
Green dot. Alright, and I saw some, yeah, there we go, some plutonium over here. Tasty. Okay. Now, let's see what else we can do here. And you need heridium. Fair enough. Right, I still need to find the freaking the beacon itself. It's around here somewhere.
Protection falling.
It's usually like right on the outskirts of the camp. There it is. Our first home. Alright, let's do one more round of selling just to keep our inventory nice and clear.
Stabilizing.
Yeah, get this Viking dagger out of here.
Units received.
Not gonna sell the plutonium because I'm gonna be using more of that.
Units received.
You can always
Units
get more of that.
Received.
And the starship is empty. Now you might say, well, Pinstar, you must be kicking yourself. You bought that tool, that 8-slot tool for that, and then the other guy just gives you a freebie 10-slot one. Well, no, I'm not kicking myself, because the way the game presents upgrades to you is based on what you have. So had I not bought this 8-slot tool before, that freebie tool that the next guy gave me probably wouldn't have been a 10-slot. It probably would have been an 8-slot. So by buying this one and then getting the freebie one, I am now upgraded to a 10-slot tool pretty darn early here, which makes me happy. Alright, we have got everything here. Oh, hang on. Yeah, let's do one more round of selling here. Sorry about that, folks. Forgot to loot those.
Temperature levels stabilized.
Just want to dump these off here.
My support power low. Units received.
And 3 power canisters. We do not need 3 power canisters.
Units received.
We just need the one. And we're about to use that one right now, so it's not taking up.
Technology recharge.
So it's not taking up our stuff. Because they're not worth that much, but they still take up a whole slot. Now, where was that Heridium Spire? I kind of like this as sort of like a home base. Heridium. There's the Heridium Spire. You know what? Let's go on a little trip here. Because we can always come back to our ship and sell again. And pick up goodies along the way. Ooh, more kryptonite over there. That'll be worth some money. Basically, anything that's kind of rare, you want to grab. Plutonium is also worth grabbing when you find it. Oops. Look at all this kryptonite. Delicious. Absolutely delicious. Aha! Now there is one reason to have a bolt caster installed, and that is if you are trying to go for a completionist, sometimes scanning the flying enemies is a less than perfect science. And if they won't register there, you shoot them down. But since we are about to climb a big old hill here, let's see if we can't scan them from atop this this mountain here. Use your jetpack to climb up raw surfaces here. Ugh. There we go. Where are you guys? Come on, register.
Come on!
I know. You can do it. I've done it before. Gotcha!
Yeah!
Perfect! Alright. I usually like taking these down from the top, down here. Soon, with a few more upgrades, this will go even faster. And by placing them all together and making them synergize with each other, it goes faster still. So, lots of ways you can improve your mining time. People who say the mining in this game is tedious probably just aren't upgrading their mining laser properly, because you can tear through some stuff pretty quickly once you get it nice and upgraded. Alright, what was it that I needed to build? The iron! I still need iron. Derp, derp, derp. Are you iron? You're iron. I need more iron than that. Might as well clean up the last of this stuff, waste not, want not, and what have you. And up here, we can get a good vantage point for scanning. Boy, lots of these flyers around here. Oh! Well, thank you for discovering... Ooh, lots of goodies down there. Pardon. Still need a little bit more, but just found a little bit more.
Thermal protection falling. Technology in.
Now these guys are getting a little bit of a synergy, not quite the full synergy, but it's a little bit more. You want them ultimately all connected, but that's the best we can do until we move the plasma launcher. But I don't want to remove the plasma launcher. It's too valuable. Alright, folks. Geronimo! Yeah, make sure you pulse the jets on the landing so you don't go splat. Aha! Inventory is full. Let us do some teleporting, shall we? So, Because these slots only hold 250, but your ship slots can hold 500, if you've got two stacks in your exosuit inventory, send it to your ship. They will combine into one stack. So Heridium and the Chrysonite goes there, and the Plutonium goes there. This one will just
technology recharge.
Use up the last of this.
Technology recharge.
Beautiful. And now we can pick up our platinum, which I think we already have stacked in our ship anyway. Yep, nothing new here. But let's pick up some platinum while we're here. And some zinc, why not? Now then. Now, one of the things we want to do before continuing on our journey and before I end the episode here is we want to make our way to the local space station. So, first off, let's upload this.
Units received.
We'll upload the rest of these.
Units received. Units received.
All right, we've discovered half the species here. Not too shabby. And that's just by accident. So, yep, point your nose to the sky, and away we go. We are officially now in space. Now, we're going to need a little bit more Thamium 9 to make it to the space station, so just harvest it from the local meteors here. There's always going to be little meteor thingies around here. Ooh, that's iron. Well, we're here anyway. We might as well, since we have open inventory slots. We'll just sell it when we get to the station. But it's really the Thamium that we're after. Sometimes you get lucky and you get some rarer stuff out in space here, like nickel or something. Alright, we should have enough to get a nice full charge here.
Technology.
And with that, we'll...
Technology,
we'll recharge the technology, large...
Recharge.
We'll get there in a day. No, that's okay. That's a bit better. Alright, folks. So, this has been an awesome end of the episode here. So, in our next episode, we're going to cover... finishing up your starter quests here, taking a look at some of the other planets, and getting your ship outfitted, and also a little bit of a warning regarding the bonus starter ship. So if you like this episode and you want to see more like it, go ahead and hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, and leave me a comment, good, bad, or indifferent. Your feedback is always welcome. So until next time, this has been Pinstar, signing out. See ya!